Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and we're going to take a look at the 2020 iPad. This is Apple's least expensive iPad, and it got a couple small upgrades this year, but it still comes in at the $329 price tag. Now, it starts at $329, it's already on discount at places like Amazon for about $30 off. Now it goes from $329 for 32 gigabytes of storage up to $429 for 128 gigabytes of storage. Now if you want cellular data, you can get it, tack on $130 extra. Now also it comes in three different colors. This is space gray. You also get silver and gold. Now let's go ahead and take a look at it. Now this is the 32 gigabyte model, and with Wi-Fi, it's not the cellular version, but this particular one, like I said, is already being discounted on Amazon, so I'll provide those links in the description. So let's go ahead and open it up. We'll take the wrapper off here. Let's open the box. And inside we have the iPad, of course. We'll set it aside. Now this is the space gray model, like I said, so we'll set that aside. Let's see what comes in the box. Now with the new Apple Watch this year, they got rid of the power adapter, but we still have one in the box of this iPad, but I think it's different than what we had in previous years. So we'll take a look at that in just a moment. Let's see what kind of documentation we have, anything different. So it looks like we have some Apple stickers in here. They're stuck. There we go. So we have Apple stickers, large Apple stickers, and then a quick start guide that gives you an overview of how to use it. And then our little warranty card and safety information. So let's set that aside. And inside, this is not what I expected. We have a USB-C to Lightning cable. So it looks like they're kind of standardizing this. And then we have a new power brick. Now this is the same sort of fast charging brick that we get with an iPhone 11 Pro Max. So you can see this is the new 20 watt power adapter. It's included in the box. So that's pretty interesting. I didn't expect that. So let's set this aside and take a closer look at the iPad. Let's take the cover off of it here. And this is a nice space gray color. And let's compare it to the previous generation, last year's model. You can see they're basically the exact same color. In previous years, they weren't necessarily the same, but they look pretty much the same as you can see here. Now it's hard to tell them apart other than that I have the previous generation on the left, but nothing else has changed on the outside with them. Now this particular device does have big changes inside. So internally, we have Apple's new A12 Bionic CPU with the Neural Engine. That's a huge update for things such as photo processing in real time and maybe editing videos. So this can definitely handle it. Now also the display hasn't changed either. So let me go ahead and turn it on, and it's the 10.2 inch display that we had in the previous generation with 2160 by 1620 pixels. It has a pixel density of 264 pixels per inch. And then it goes up to 500 nits of brightness, has an oleophobic coating, and it supports the first generation Apple Pencil. So I'll set this up in a moment, but as you can see along the outside edge, it's very familiar. Looks like any other iPad. On the bottom, we have our Lightning port along with stereo speakers. On the right hand side, we have volume rockers. So you can see here, there's two volume buttons. On the top, we have our power sleep wake button. We have a microphone, and we still have a headphone jack. On the left hand side, we have our pogo pin adapters, or our smart connector as Apple calls it. And then we have Touch ID on the front. So it should be pretty good. We'll see if it's the second generation. Now on the back, we have the same camera. We have the 8-megapixel camera with an f2.4 aperture, and it records up to 1080p 30 frames per second video. On the front, we have a very not so great camera. It works basically for FaceTime calls, and it's a 1.2 megapixel camera that's really only good for those sort of calls. Internally, we have Wi-Fi 802.11 A, B, G, N, and AC. There's no Wi-Fi 6. And battery life should be about 10 hours, just like we get with everything else. Although this chipset inside the A12 Bionic is more efficient than the previous generation's A10 Fusion CPU. So it should be pretty nice. They're basically identical in every way externally from the previous generation, but you get a much faster CPU. So if we flip this over here, I'll just show you really quickly before I set this up. go to English, we'll turn on the other one, and side by side, you have the exact same displays. There's nothing new here. Basically, everything is exactly the same, so you have a much faster CPU, but everything else stays the same. Now let's go ahead and set up Touch ID. So I'll place my fingerprint on the fingerprint sensor. And it looks pretty fast. Usually the first generation Touch ID was much slower. So it seems to be second generation or maybe even a newer version. There we go. We'll go to the next one, adjust the grip, move our fingerprint around. And it works really well once it's set up. So if you've ever used the fingerprint sensor, it's super nice and it's secure on the chip. Apple doesn't share it outside of the device. So I'll wait for this to finish and then we'll take a closer look. Now everything's set up. I didn't transfer any data. I just wanted to see what it was like, but let's take a look and see what version OS comes pre-installed with it. So if I go to General, then About, so you can see it comes pre-installed with iOS 14. And so if we go home, let's take a closer look. So this particular device, it does work with Apple Pencil, like I said, but before we take a look at that, the good thing is all the previous generation accessories from the previous iPad that you could buy last year will work with this iPad. So for example, if you have this Combi Touch keyboard set up with a trackpad, it will work on this iPad. So the case will fit without a problem. So let's put it in place so I can show you. So you'll see it fits nicely around the outside edge. No problem there. Everything's in place. And if we attach the keyboard, we'll get all the keyboard functionality with a trackpad if you want to buy this accessory. So we'll ignore that for now. And you'll see that I can use the trackpad to move around the screen. You can hit Control or Command Space and you get search. So with this, you get all the same keyboards and accessories that you can use with previous generations. So it's really nice that they've kept this the same size and it works just fine. So let's see if I can remove this here. And if you have a case that you used with maybe last year's iPad, maybe you want to pass it on to a family member, you can use that. Now to pair the Apple Pencil, you just plug it in. Now it's not compatible with the second generation Apple Pencil. So let's go ahead and plug this in. It will pair. It takes just a moment. It may need to charge as well. So we'll give it just a moment to charge up and we'll hit pair. And we should be good to go. We should be able to use it now. It says, welcome to Apple Pencil. And it's telling us about the new features. So now you get all the new features of iPad OS 14. Now, once you have an Apple Pencil paired, because we have all of the same modern updates as we get with the iPad Pro, we can do the same sorts of things. So if we go into Notes, for example, and I'll just write Zolotech. I don't normally write like that, but we'll write Zolotech. And if I press and hold on it, I can select it. Tap on my pencil options, change the color. And this is a new feature of iPad OS 14. And then again, if I select it, let's get rid of the pencil options there. If I select it, I can move it around, do whatever I want with this text. It's really intuitive and great to use. So if you've never used this before, it's something that I think you'll really appreciate with the new features, but also you get all the benefits of the higher end iPads minus a few features. But because it has the A12 Bionic in it, it's super fast. You can edit 4K video with iMovie. You can manipulate photos in real time using the editor. It's just incredibly intuitive and very, very fast. And you're not really missing out other than having stereo speakers and a higher refresh rate on your display. Otherwise, you've got most of the benefits of the Pro device, even with the accessories such as Logitech's keyboard. So that's it for the 2020 iPad. Now, this device is something I recommend all the time to people that don't have iPads. Even if you just need a computer around the house and you need something that's a little less expensive that you don't have to worry about, it's what I would recommend to most people if you've never tried an iPad. And even if you have tried an iPad, if you have an older one, maybe an iPad 2 or an iPad Air, the original one, it's still worth picking up. It's a great value and it's even cheaper than the original iPad at $329. The original was $499. So this is a great value. So again, I highly recommend it. And if you do pick one up, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. What did you pick up? Did you get an iPad Air, iPad Pro, or maybe even an older one? Let me know in the comments below. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.